A lot of people say, well, you know, you physicians, you should be confined to your offices. We feel as though, really, if we can't get out and intervene in our, and help our patients, then we ought to make sure that the tobacco companies might be prevented from doing that as well.
Conference organizers say the effect of advertising on teenagers is potent.
Let's look at who is the target population. Do you take up cigarette smoking? Do I? There obviously is a clear aim at the market that's going to take up cigarette smoking, and that's the 8 to 21-year-olds.
According to a recent nationwide survey, more doctors smoke Camels than any other cigarette.
Three leading independent research organizations asked this question of 113,597 doctors.
You really, really love me. What?
You coughed up. Long enough, baby. Says Mississippi Doc. Doctors ought to care.
The Surgeon General, Dr. Luther Terry, holds a press conference. Packed to the brim, the reporters were locked in the room and given 1.5 hours to read the report and then to pose questions to Dr. Terry. This is the letter that was sent by Dr. Terry the following week to every physician in the United States, along with a copy of the report, urging physicians to read and look at the conclusions and to act accordingly.
The Center for the Study of Tobacco and Society at the University of Alabama is home to the nation's largest and most comprehensive collection of original tobacco industry documents and artifacts, cigarette marketing, and strategies for ending the smoking pandemic in the clinic, classroom, and community. The archive comprises more than 100 extensive and unique collections, including health claims and cigarette advertising.
Doctors in all parts of the country were asked, "What cigarette do you smoke, doctor?" Once again, the brand named most was Camel.
Children in smoking.
What better way to get a kid to do something than to tell him he's not old enough or mature enough to do it now?
Tobacco sponsorship of sports and the arts.
Mirrors, of course, number 3, the Marlboro car, lined up right behind.
What's so sad and so amazing is that this is totally illegal.
Minorities in smoking.
It's very clear to us that the black community in particular has been targeted to promote tobacco, cigarettes.
Smokeless tobacco.
Just a pinch gives me real tobacco pleasure without lighting up anytime, anywhere.
Cigars. Hospitals and smoking. And indoor and clean air legislation. This expansive collection was curated by Dr. Alan Blum, professor and Dr. Gerald Leon Wallace Endowed Chair in Family Medicine at the University of Alabama, a pioneering anti-smoking advocate who wrote his first article on the dangers of tobacco as editor of his high school newspaper in 1964. In the 1980s, as editor of the New York State Journal of Medicine and the Medical Journal of Australia, Dr. Blum published the first ever theme issues on the tobacco pandemic at any medical journal in the world. The collection also chronicles the efforts of the first medical anti-smoking organization, the 5,000 physicians strong Doctors Ought to Care, or DOC. Much of the center's efforts have focused on implementing processes for the preservation and organization of the collection and the creation of online exhibitions, presentations and posters at scientific conferences, original articles for both medical journals and the lay press, and documentary films.
He has now begun to mine this data set by picking out themes and tracing those themes through his the archives over time and over space and through different populations, and is able to really put together a narrative about how the smoking epidemic has been engendered and supported and created through the years.
The center has developed a strategy for its own projects that utilizes the collection in order to have the broadest reach and the maximum impact on society. As of the end of 2018, the center has created more than 10 entirely new or completely reimagined exhibitions and collections on its website, with more planned for release in 2019. Future exhibitions will feature The History of Doctors Ought to Care, a retrospective on tobacco advertising, remasters of Big Tobacco and the Big Apple, and Op and Smoke, the airline flight attendant's fight to end smoking aloft, medical claims in tobacco advertising, and an investigation of the deep roots of tobacco in America's pastime, baseball.
The Center for the Study of Tobacco and Society is a leading repository on documenting the tobacco issue and other issues of public health. It's also a leading research center experimenting with developing new ways of disseminating archival narratives. It's also a critical education site. The Center for the Study of Tobacco and Society and the School of Library and Information Studies have long had an educational partnership with dozens of students formally and informally interning with the center. Many of these students have gone on to work in leading repositories across the country.
The archive holds far more than its unique collection of materials. It also contains key backstories that need to be told and that only the center can tell. These are stories that resonate with and astonish those who seek to learn more about all sides of the tobacco issue. The center provides these stories from a variety of perspectives, illustrated by materials that few, if any, have thought to preserve in their original historical context.
I think that overall, this issue shouldn't have required any great courage. This issue was common sense. And the saddest thing is the most addictive thing about tobacco is money. And that's not just the tobacco industry. That's people who get a grant to study it. We don't need any more studying of tobacco. We really don't. We need to do something about it now. And we've been saying this for over 40, 50 years. And anybody who's silent on looking at the selling of the product that kills more people in the United States than any other really ought to be ashamed of himself. And it's not just the people selling, it's the people who remain silent in the face of this ongoing tragedy.
Puff, puff, puff. Oh, you can puff your cares away. Puff.